In compositing effects, lighting can be key to get it to look just right. With our EXR files, you're given full customization by getting access to multiple lighting passes like key, fill, rim, fire, and more. In this video, I'm going to show you how to properly set up and use your EXR file inside of Nuke so that you get the most out of your ActionVFX asset. Let's just jump into it. So we have our explosion here, and then I have a background image. First thing we're going to do is shuffle out the different EXR passes. We have four of them in this asset. We have our key light, and I'm going to copy and paste for each of these. In our fill light. And our rim light. And lastly, we have the explosion light, which is just the fire. Now we're going to merge these together. This can be done with a single merge node like this, or it can be done with multiple merge nodes. When doing more complex edits, I would suggest using multiple nodes, but for the simplicity of this, we can do it all with one. We're going to do a plus operation, and right off the bat, you can see how our edges look much darker than what they did before. And if I disable these new nodes, you can see the difference before and after. So next we're going to unpremult the image. This is going to allow us to make adjustments to the image and ensure that the edges are handled correctly. And lastly, we're going to put a copy node down at the bottom, Shift X to switch our input because we want the background input to be input coming from our merge node. And then our A channel will be coming from our original image. What this is going to do is copy the alpha channel from the original image into our new chain down here. And then we can simply pre-multiply the image to the end to handle the alpha pre-multiplication. So now if I disable these, other than a very slight change in the fire, you can see that these are a match in all of the smoke. There's no difference in any of the smoke channels. And what we can do now is add exposure adjustments or color correction adjustments. So if I wanted to reduce the key light, then I can add an exposure. And I can easily expose down on that key light and we'll have less of it. Or I can go up and we'll have a lot more of it. And you can see that these edges are behaving correctly. Nothing looks odd. If I were to turn off this unpremult, then you'll see we start getting those dark edges. So that's why we need to unpremultiply before we make any adjustments to the image. And then we can also, let's say if we wanted to make this a strong backlight scene, then we can add the same exposure node here to our backlight, and then we can turn it up so we have more of that backlight coming through. And it's very easy to make any type of adjustment, exposure, color correction, any type of grade to any of these channels. And that's how you set up our multi-channel EXR files. Let us know in the comments down below what tutorial you'd like to see next. Don't forget to head on over to actionvfx.com where you can browse the world's largest library of 2D and 3D assets ready for film, games, and television. With that said, get out there and start creating, and I'll see you on the next one.